me, sir. Mind if I take a little peek at you? I promise I'll be brief. My goodness, what a strapping physique. Capable of an astounding variety of acts of violence, I imagine.
What is happening?
This must be the squirrel that tends the world tree.
That delectable aroma. Could it be? Pardon the intrusion. Ah, yes. Amber resin. Delightfully nutty with a hint of squid ink.
No.
Not one for gastronomic exploration, I see.
Wait, if you're Ratatosker, why are you so different when we summon you for help?
It's a long story. But you are correct. I am indeed Ratatosker. The one you know as Ratatosker is merely one of my spectral aspects. And a particularly nasty one at that. I consider him so far removed from myself that he's practically a different person. Speaking of, Bitter, would you like to come out and see your friends?
Fuck off! I'm busy!
I suppose that was to be expected. Anyway, now that I've polished off all this resin for you, would you like the seed back?
It is the seed.
Indeed. A seed of Yggdrasil, to be precise. Since my dwarven tenants performed their little reconfiguration, you'll need seeds like these to open up new destinations on my tree.
Your tree, huh?
Yes, my tree. Here, let me show you. So that's why good Master Brock needed an alpine seed. Clearly, you have important matters afoot. That seed you found unlocks Niflheim, of all places, a realm as ancient as it is vaguely sticky.
Perhaps as we travel, you can tell me the tale of your prior visit to the land of the elves.
Sure, I can. Alfheim was the first time we ever realm traveled using your temple. Freya tried coming with us, but Odin cast a spell on her. She can't leave Midgard.
That's terrible.
So then we fought our way through an army of dark elves to get to the light.
You interfered in the elf war.
Not by choice. We sought to fill our Bifrost, and they attacked us.
The Dark Elves were covering it with their sticky hive stuff. When we freed it, Light Elves came back. We seemed better in Alfheim.
Did they now? Alfheim. It's been so long.
Not sure where the temple is from here, but that's where we'll find Groa's shrine.
Broken history. Aye, not exactly an easy fix for that.
I see the elves continue their war.
Yeah, so much for things being better in Alfheim. Yikes. Fimbulwinter hit Alfheim hard.
No. Storms have plagued Alfheim's deserts long before Fimbulwinter.
The living desert. Huh?
Hold on. I hear something out there. Something big. It's in pain.
Our goal is at the temple, not in the desert.
The Temple of Light.
Groa's shrine is at the top.
Freyr never bothered returning to Alfheim, did he, Mimir?
Aye, no. I assumed the fate of his own realm took precedence.
Wait. Freyr's body?
Yes. Cut from a different cloth, that one.
There's a barricade up ahead. What are those shiny rocks?
Twilight Stone. A rare material that can take millennia to form. Majestic, isn't it? Occasionally, the light of Alfheim will bind to a rock and crystallize, growing like moss on a fallen tree. Truly a wonder of the Nine Realms. Oh, I didn't know it could do that.
There's a gap in the fence over there.
Get off him!
There's a gap in the fence over there. There's a gap in the fence over there.
Very clever.
Another rat! To the left!
Freya's brother. How was he involved?
Long ago, Freyr of the Vanir traveled to Alfheim, where he discovered a once beautiful land devastated by war. Using his divine powers, he set about cultivating a tenuous peace among the elves.
Did you mention how that peace fell apart as soon as he left?
We're getting to it.
You hear that?
Oh, no.
That's enough, please. You don't need to do this.
We don't want to hurt you.
We do not have a choice.
We're the ones who bring the light. Why are you fighting us? We helped you last time.
Atreus, focus.
Hey, Alpha! Is that a ball?
What's your
life?
Most unfortunate.
They attacked us.
More will follow once we're inside. Is there truly no other way?
Not like they're giving us much of a choice.
So your father said. I'm just naive, I suppose.
No. Just an optimist, old friend. Tribute to Freyr, made by the elves. He must have left it here when he raced back to Vanaheim.
What is this?
A charm to ward off nightmares. In this case, Freyr's. Well, knowing the elves, there are probably more tributes to find.
So tall. We came in from the top last time. I didn't realize all this was even done here.
It's an older gate, built to promote cooperation between the elves. But it looks like it's been sealed for some time.
How do we enter?
Grab that wheel and I'll show you.
I'll go first. Atreus, let me know when I've reached halfway.
So, what's happening right now?
This seal is meant to represent the balance of the realm when Freyr was here. Light and dark, working together in harmony.
How's that look, Atreus?
Good, I think. Father, now you go.
Unfortunately for Alfheim, Freyr couldn't accept his sister's decision to marry Odin. He returned to Vanaheim and left this realm to its fate.
To be fair, the Aesir did set him on fire that one time.
The door should have opened. Are you sure it's balanced?
Yeah, but the realm isn't. Not anymore. Father, try pulling it the other way. Yeah, yeah! And Tyr, you keep pushing forward.
Fine work, Atreus. Shall we?
What's a Dark Elf statue doing in the Light Temple?
That's just how they looked before the Division.
The Division?
Yes. The Elves weren't always split between Light and Dark, you know. This statue depicts an Elf before the war. Before they discovered the power of the Light.
Solid light. Guess some things don't change. Above the door, there's a light crystal.
Stone briefly imparts a bit of light to your axe.
That's useful. What's that sound?
No sense in spoiling the surprise.
Oh, it's the light!
I've never seen the Lake of Souls so volatile.
Aye. Fimbulwinter, you reckon?
Of course. Making the light unstable.
So the base of this light well, that's the Lake of Souls.
Yes. After the creation of the Nine Realms, fallen souls began to gather down in those waters.
When the Elves discovered its potential, they built this temple to harness that energy. A smashing success, to say the least.
Many of them became addicted to their newfound power, and thus, the Light Elves. Well done. Though I imagine our Light Elf friends will be less than pleased.
Speaking of Light Elves...
Let me try talking to them again. They
Thanks
may...
just to let these two do their thing, brother.
Watch out!
What's your life?
On light bridges, but now the bridges are gone.
I have an idea to get us across. Follow these friends.
Lucky for us, swearing off violence doesn't mean he can't disfigure some architecture.
This way. Shrine awaits.
Temple looks so different than I remember. It was all broken and covered in hive stuff last time we were here.
These elves use Alfheim's light to enhance the temple, and themselves by the look of it.
They definitely look more dangerous than last time.
Oh, those were just the foot soldiers. They'll get more dangerous the further up we go.
Great. So if these elves use the light to build doors and make themselves stronger, what do the Dark Elves want with it?
To return it back to its source. To them, the natural resources of Alfheim are sacred, none more so than the Light itself.
Aye. The Light Elf's success came at a terrible price. Alfheim's once lively desert withered into a storm-ridden wasteland soon after the creation of this temple.
There's more Twilight Stone up there.
More inspiring lyricism from the mind of Gvasia.
There's gotta be a better angle on that spiral.
More light elves ahead. I'll handle this.
Maybe that's not a great idea.
Oh there, friends. Salutations. We mean you no harm.
Tyr! Get back!
Behind you! Incoming!
And the light left alone. But the light elves want to keep using them.
That's the long and short of it. Aye.
So then, which side is right?
Clearly isn't so simple.
And not our place to say. This is an elven conflict.
I said as much the last time we were in Alfheim.
Right. Sure made a lot of these light doors.
Fortifications.
Aye. None too eager to let the Dark Elves run the roost again.
Why not simply hold it in place?
Jump!
The angle looks right. Right.
Excellent. Let's continue our ascent, yes?
Kvasir.
Ripped apart by his audience. Well, one member of his audience. Well, Thor.
I suppose I'll leave you to it then.
Left side!
Come on, get up, brother!
I suppose I'll leave you to it then.
I suppose I'll leave you to it.
Ah, this is a fine mess.